Hello friends, I am Rajgopal discussing cyber law. In the previous sessions we have discussed different sections under Information Technology Act 2000. Let us continue with that. In today's agenda, let us take up. In the previous class we have discussed cyber regulation appellate tribunal, establishment of CRAT, composition, qualification of presiding officer, term of the office, salary and other allowances, filling up of vacancies, resignation and removal, staff of CRAT, who will going to appoint, okay, appeal, how we have to go for an appeal to cyber appellate tribunal, all these things we have discussed in the last few sessions. In the today's agenda, we will take up the offenses, which is an important part in the cyber law. What are all the different types of offenses? What is the punishment that will be imposed when a person commits that particular mistake? That and all we will going to discuss in this today's session. This is actually chapter 9 of Information Technology Act 2000. Okay, here we are going to discuss about different types of offenses like tampering with computer source document, hacking with computer system, punishment for receiving the computer stolen resources, punishment for identity theft, punishment for cheating and personation, punishment for privacy violence, punishment for cyber terrorism, punishment for cyber terrorism and punishment for publishing of information which is obscene, publishing of or transmitting the sexually explicit act in electronic form, power of controller to give directions, government agencies power to intercept the information. What do you mean by protected systems? What is the penalty for misrepresentation of the identity? What is the penalty for breach of confidentiality and privacy? And what is the power to investigate the offenses? Who will be having the power to investigate the offenses? All these things let us discuss in the today's class, my dear friends. Here, the first one, under the Information Technology Act 2000, tampering with computer source information, okay, source document, tampering the information from the computer source document, that is under section 65. Okay, section 65 will clearly gives the information about what is the computer source document, how a person will be punished for doing intentionally these mistakes under section 65. Whoever knowingly or intentionally conceals, destroys or alters computer source code, computer program, computer system or computer network shall be punishable with an imprisonment and fine up to rupees 2 lakh or both. Okay, so whoever intentionally destroys, alters, okay, this computer source code program will be punishable with an imprisonment and a fine up to 2 lakhs or both. Here if we want to see one case study, my dear friends, in Asfajuddin case and other in Andhra Pradesh, okay, one case was registered, a Tata Indica employee, against Tata Indica employee, for manipulation of electronic 32-bit number, ESN number, we will call it as ESN number, programmed into cell phones, theft were exclusively franchised to Reliance Infocom. Okay, so this is a case registered under section 65 in Andhra Pradesh. FIR has been filed against the accused and he has been interrogated for this. And the court held that, after inquiry, the court held that the tampering with the source code involves section 65. He has committed the mistake under section 65 and he has been punished under this particular act only. Okay, so here a person has taken the source code, he has modified or destroyed. Here actually he has modified the source code and he has transmitted to some other person. Okay, that is a clear violation of section 65 of Information Technology Act. The court has given a decision verdict telling that this is a punishable under section 65. Okay, so next, section 66. If a person dishonestly or fraudulently does any act referred to in section 43 we have already discussed, he shall be punished with an imprisonment for a term which may extend to 3 years or a fine which may extend to 5 lakh or both. Okay, who commits a mistake, okay, whatever it is referred in section 43, he will be punished with an imprisonment of 3 years or a fine which may extend up to 5 lakh. Okay, there are different sections, subsections in section 66. First one, section 66A, okay, which will be a punishment for sending an offensive messages through communication devices. Okay, offensive messages, putting comment on which will hurt the community, which will hurt the population, that will be treated as cyber crime and it will be punished under section 66A of, or under, mainly under 66 of IT Act. Here what happens is, I can give you one example, my dear friends. In one case registered in 2012, on 19th November 2012, one girl has posted on the Facebook for whatever the band which has taken place in Bombay, okay, for at the time when an highest dignitary has died, that is Mr. Balsaheb Thackeray, has been for his procession, the complete band has been announced in Bombay. She has commented something about that. And one girl of 19 year has liked that. Both were taken into custody at that time, for it is hurting the mass people over this particular issue. So a lot of debate has taken place over this issue. Finally, the court has given, Supreme Court, it has gone up to Supreme Court. Supreme Court has given decision that under this Act 66A, there should not be any arrest. Okay, so here the police have filed an FIR and they have taken into the custody. Okay, then keeping this in mind, the Supreme Court has struck down this 66A and given an historic decision that the person cannot be taken into custody. They have to investigate the matter and then it has to be proceeded accordingly. Okay, this is 66A of the Information Technology Act. Next, 66B, receiving the stolen computer or resources. Okay, if any case has been registered under this, okay, he shall be punished with the imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend up to 3 years or with a fine up to 1 lakh, or it can be both. Here 66B means stolen, if you receive or if you have the custody of stolen computer, if somebody steals a computer which is there in some other's custody, in a legal custody, then it can be punished. And if you receive that stolen computer, if you buy that stolen computer, or if that stolen computer is in your custody at that particular point of time, you will be punished under this section. Okay, you will be punished under this section. In one more case, I can give one example under this case. In this case, the accused has gained unauthorized access to the Joint Academy Network, JANET, and deleted, added files, changed the password to deny the access to authorized users. Investigation has revealed that Kumar was logging on to the BSNL broadband network as he was an authorized G9 user and made alterations to the computer database pertaining to that. And a complaint has been registered in Chennai, okay, and Bangalore. He was operating from Bangalore and Chennai. And finally, the verdict has been given by additional Chief Metropolitan Magistrate Egmore, Chennai, has sentenced Mr. Arun Kumar, the techie from Bangalore, to undergo a rigorous imprisonment for 1 year with a fine of 5,000 under Section 420 of IPC and under Section 66 of Information Technology Act for doing the computer offences, computer related offences. So if anybody receives a computer, will be punished under this section. Okay, will be punished under this section. And punishment for identity theft, my dear friends. Which will be, clearly wrongly it is written as 66B, it is 66C. However, fraudulently make use of electronic signature, password or unique identification number, okay, future of any person shall be punished with an imprisonment for a term which may extend up to 3 years or a fine of 1 lakh rupees. Okay, if anybody who does the identity theft means using somebody's electronic signature, misusing somebody's electronic signature unauthorizedly using the password of some other person. Okay, that will be known as theft of identification. If you use a identification of another person for your purpose, then it will be known as identity theft, which will be punishable under Section 66C of Information Technology Act. Okay, here I want to give one example. 2 to 3 years back, one news has come in the newspaper telling that one person, what he has done is he has published his own obituary in the newspaper. With that, he got the certificate of death, and then he has obtained one more license, a learner's license in some other's name. Okay, and again he has taken that, he has used for taking the credit card. He has done so many manipulations in this, and the main intention was to take one more credit card and to use it unauthorizedly. Okay, he has been taken into custody and he has been given a punishment under Section 66C of Information Technology Act, where he has done a theft of identity of his own. He has misused it. Okay, he has misused it to take a credit card, and this will be a punishable offense under Section 66 of Information Technology Act. Okay, next, Section 66D of Information Technology Act, cheating by personation by using the computer resources. My dear friends, 66D, personation, means if you are not an authorized user of a system, you can't enter into that particular system. Okay, if you unnecessarily enter into that particular system where you are not supposed to enter, then it will be a case of impersonation. Okay, where it is a case of personation, you will be using some other's identity to enter into the system of one more person. Here you will be punished with an imprisonment of 3 years and a fine which may extend to 1 lakh rupees. Okay, it is a means of cheating. Okay, it is by means of cheating. Okay, by entering into some other's system and making use of the facilities which are available. With one example, I can explain here. One relevant case, okay, where Sandeep Varghese versus State of Kerala, a complaint was filed by the representative company which was engaged in the business of trading and distribution of petrochemicals in India overseas, India and overseas. A crime was registered against 9 persons alleging the offences under section 65, 66, 66 CAD of the Information Technology Act and under section 419, 420 of Indian Penal Code. Okay, what has happened in this case is one person who was an employee who has been terminated from that company for his misbehavior in the company. Okay, he has created an website in the name, okay, in the same name by varying one letter of that particular company website. He has created his own website which will be similar to the company's website, looks similar to the company's website, and he has given a wrong information about the director's company, okay, and everything. He used to give a wrong information, derogatory information he used to company, he used to give against the company where he was working. Along with him, 9 other people were also involved in doing this particular thing. Okay, so defamatory, malicious matters were published against the company. This is a serious offense of personation. Okay, this is an offense by cheating personation. He has created a fake mails. He has sent the some information using that fake mails. All these things has happened, and finally all they were punished by the court of law under this section 66D and so many other sections under section 420 and 419 where it involves cheating, okay, under section IPC, and he has been punished with a rigorous imprisonment and a fine up to some 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs like that. He has been punished. So here what I want to explain you here is, if you create somebody's mail ID, okay, by giving their address and all these things, if you cheat them, okay, that will be a case of impersonation. Okay, so that will be a serious case of impersonation, and you will be punished under this particular act. Okay, so violation of piracy under section privacy under section 66 of IT Act, 66E of IT Act. Privacy means entering into somebody's private areas intentionally, knowingly, or whatever may be, entering into the private areas of some other person, okay, without their knowledge, okay, without their knowledge, okay, without taking their permission, publishing the same in the electronic media or whatever may be. So that will be a violation of privacy under section 66E of IT Act. Intentionally or unknowingly captures, publishes or transmits the images of private area of any person without his or her consent under any circumstances, violating the privacy of that person shall be punished with an imprisonment which may extend to 3 years or with a fine up to 2 lakh rupees. Okay, so this is a serious case of violation of privacy. Okay, so one relevant case I can explain here. In Jawaharlal Nehru University, okay, that is MMS scandal. Okay, in the severe shock of the prestigious and renowned institution Jawaharlal University, a pornographic MMS clip was apparently made in the campus and transmitted outside the university. Okay. Some media reports claim that two accused were there. Two accused students initially tried to extort the money from that particular girl. Okay. Once they were not getting the money, they started telling that they used to harass her. After that, they have made a CD and they have floated into the market. Okay. So that is a serious case of violation of privacy. So all the accused were arrested, and the action was taken, and FIR has been filed, and the court has given a punishment of imprisonment and fine of some amount. So because they have done a criminal act under section 66E of IT Act, Information Technology, where they have captured the private parts of the particular person unknowingly, and they have threatened her for a money, and finally they have made a CD and they have sold in the market. Okay, so this is a complete violation of section 66E of Information Technology Act. And one more scandal of similar type in Nagpur. One Nagpur Congress leader has done an MMS scandal. The police have arrested two engineering students. Okay, where they have harassed a 16-year-old girl by circulating the MMS clip, okay, which contains their sexual acts. Okay, and then the two students were taken into custody. A case was registered under different acts and also under section 66E, and they were punished for the same. Okay, this is about the 66E. And next, the 66F, cyber terrorism. So with an intent, the cyber terrorism means terror. The broad meaning of the word terrorism means creating or threatening a community, okay, with some act. Okay, that is known as the terrorism. Creating a false calls, okay, sending a false information, or that is a hoax calls that there is a bomb in some places, in some malls. All these will be considered as a cyber terrorism. So let us see, with the intent to threaten the unity, integrity, security, sovereignty of India, or to strike terror in people, which is very much important, okay, so which will strike terror in the people or any section of people by denying access. Now this is not just a hoax call, by denying the access, okay, attempting to penetrate, introducing a containment, all these will be considered as cyber terrorism, okay, which will be, and if you are working for the advantage of some other country, okay, then also it will be considered as cyber terrorism. For that, you will be punished with a life imprisonment, okay, which can be extended up to life imprisonment. All these acts will be considered as a cyber terrorism, by denying the access, attempting to penetrate, introducing the containment into the system, which will terrorize the people, will be considered as cyber terrorism. Okay, so one example I can give you here, the Mumbai police have registered a case of cyber terrorism. In that, in the first state, since the amendment of the Information Technology Act, okay, where a threat email was sent to BSE and NSE, Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange, okay, and Mumbai police and cyber crime police have done the investigation jointly, and they have traced the cell phone, and one person has been taken into custody for creating this threatening email and sending it to BSC and NSC, where the entire day of that particular BSC and the NSC has been wasted. Okay, so many people all over India involved in the trading activity have been affected with that false email. Okay, they have traced that email, they have arrested that person, and then a case has been registered and he has been punished with the Cyber Terrorism Act of Cyber Terrorism under Section 66F of Information Technology Act. Here, cyber terrorism means a group of people is seriously affected by either it may be your by through your phone call or by through your emails or by accessing denying the access to a group of systems, okay, attempting to penetrate, all these things which will affect a group of people as a whole, okay, will be considered as cyber terrorism. Next, this is up to 66F, which will cover Section 66 of Information Technology Act, different subsections. Next, let us go to Section 67 of Information Technology Act. Publishing or transmitting obscene material in electronic form. Okay. Whoever publishes any material which is obscene or prurient interest shall be punished for a term which may extend to 10 years and also with a fine which may extend to 2 lakh rupees. Okay, that is the Section 67 of Information Technology Act. Okay, if somebody is transmitting the obscene material, obscene means which is not accepted, which will create some distress among the people who go through that particular material, will be called as obscene material. Okay. Section 67 will give 10 years imprisonment. Okay. According to the 10 year imprisonment and a fine up to 2 lakh rupees can be imposed under this particular section. One relevant case is, okay, defamatory and annoying messages about a diverse woman in Yahoo message group. Email were forwarded to the victim for information by the accused through a false email account opened by him in the name of the victim. Okay, these postings resulted in annoying phone calls to the lady. One person, here it is a very interesting case, my dear friends. One lady has been arranged a marriage with some one person. Okay, finally that marriage has cancelled and he has married some other person. That first person who was about to marry has created an email in her name. Okay, false email and in her name, and through that mail he has sent the information, okay, some obscene materials, okay, through that mail to different group of people, from that group of people, that particular lady started getting the unnecessary phone calls, okay, which was disturbing her mental status and which was creating a disturbance in her mind. Okay, so that is publishing transmitting obscene material. The people were thinking she was only sending the message, but she was not sending. In her name an email was created and that person who has been accused was sending the mails through that particular mail which was created in her name. Okay, based on lady's complaint, the police nabbed the accused. They have traced from which mobile or from which computer, okay, this particular mail has been created. They have traced and then they have identified that person and they finally he was taken into custody and produced before the court. The court has given the verdict. The accused was found guilty of the offence of the section along with section 67. He has been accused of the section 469, 509 of IPC and 67 of IT Act 2000, and he is convicted and sentenced for offence. Okay, he has been convicted and sentenced for the offence. He has been punished, okay, under 469 of IPC, 2 year imprisonment, pay fine of 500 rupees. Under 509 of IPC, he has been 1 year simple imprisonment and a fine of 500 rupees. Under section 67 of IT Act 2000, he has to go for 2 year imprisonment and a fine up to 4000 rupees. All sentences were to run concurrently. Okay, so this was the decision given by the court under the section 67. So here the friends, so the Indian Penal Code different section will also be there for cheating, for all these things. So I, especially if a person is using the electronic form, electronic media or computer, then the IT Act will also get attracted along with the other acts which he has done the mistakes. Okay. So this is section 67 of Information Technology Act. Next, section 67, there is one more thing is there. Section 67B is also there. Okay, let us discuss that also. Section 67A, whoever publishes the material which contains sexually explicit act or conduct shall be punishable with an imprisonment which may extend to 7 years and also a fine which may extend to 10 years. Okay, that is a 67A, which will publishes the material which contains sexually explicit act, a porn movie or anything, if you publish that, then this section 67A will attract and you will be punished. A person will be punished for the same with an imprisonment of 7 years and also fine which may extend to 10 lakh rupees. Okay. In that particular case, okay, we can give previous examples only we can take. Okay, where the person will get an imprisonment for transmitting the MMS or whatever may be. Okay, that is one thing. And then section 67B. Okay, section 67B punishment. Here I have not written explicitly. Okay, that is child pornography, which is a very heinous offense. Punishment for publishing or transmitting a material depicting children in sexual explicit act in an electronic form, they will be punished with which may extend up to life imprisonment or imprisonment up to 10 years. Here one case, okay, which has been decided by the Supreme Court of India, and an information order has been passed to the government of India on 10-3-2010. To a public interest litigation, the petition sought a blanket ban on pornographic websites. Okay, where the Supreme Court has given a decision, blanket ban, no one scene, okay, nothing has to be published again with the child pornography. Okay, a serious the central government has to take all the precautionary actions to ban this child pornography in any form in any of the websites. Okay, and if anybody publishes the same, he will be punished with a heavy fine and with a life which may extend up to life imprisonment. Okay, that is one case where the Supreme Court has clear instructions to the central government in a public interest litigation, which has given a blanket ban on the child pornographic situations. Okay, so here next let us go to the section 68, power of the controller to give directions. Any person who fails to comply with any order of the controller shall be guilty of an offense and shall be liable on a conviction to imprisonment for a term not exceeding 3 years and a fine of not exceeding 2 lakh rupees. Okay, there is a power to the central government, okay, to, as we have in the last few sessions we have discussed, they have the power to get the reports from a certifying authority or some digital signature certificate holders. They can ask for a report, timely reports has to be given. The power is there. If somebody will not go accordingly, okay, if some CA certifying authority will not submit the report properly, whichever is asked by the controller, then they are punishable with a with an imprisonment of up to 2 years or 3 years and a fine of up to 2 lakh rupees. Okay. So this is the power of the director, controller to give the directions. Okay, next. Power to intercept the information. This act empowers the central or the state government authority, the agency, to intercept, monitor or decrypt any information generated, transmitted, received or stored in any computer. See my dear friends, whenever some act has taken place through the computer, quite naturally the investigating authorities has to intercept the information, has to trace the information from where they have got. Okay, at that time it needs all the systems, service providers, okay, service providers support to get into that, to go into that inquiry. Okay, so here the central government or the state government authority agency has the power to investigate into the matter. Then everybody has to give a proper support to go into the investigation, to monitor or decrypt the information which is generated, from where it has been transmitted, from which mail ID this has been transmitted, what is the methods that they have used, who are all the service providers who are involved, okay, with that, all these things, all the, it will empower the central government to take the support of all these things for getting into the investigation. Okay, the agency can also secure all facilities and technical assistance from subscriber to decrypt the information. Okay, they can ask for the information from the subscriber if they want to decrypt the information. If somebody fails to do that, okay, if somebody fails to do that, then the person who fails to assist the agency shall be punishable with an imprisonment which may extend up to 7 years. Okay, if somebody will not give the information, if somebody avoids to give the information, if somebody destroys that particular, tries to destroy that information, then they will be punishable under Section 69 of Information Technology Act. Okay, under Section 69, all the central government, state government, will, the agency will have the power to intercept into the matter. Okay, to take the control of particular system or whatever may be. Okay, if somebody will not, or if somebody fails to give the information, they can be punishable up to 7 years. Okay, in one case where in August 2007, okay, Lakshman Kailas, a techie from Bangalore, has been arrested, okay, with an offense suspecting that he has published insulting images of Chhatrapati Shivaji. Okay, Chhatrapati Shivaji. Police and a complaint has been lodged. The police have got the IP address and they have identified the service provider as an Airtel. They have got the IP address and they have given the information to the service provider that who has generated this. They have traced and they have come to know that the Lakshman has generated this particular information through his ISP, and he has been taken into custody, and then he has been rigorously detained for 50 days. Okay, rigorously detained for 50 days, and finally, okay, they have found that the police have given a wrong information to the Airtel service provider that at 1:15, okay, at 1:15 this particular instance has happened. Okay, so unnecessarily they have taken the custody, and it has made the authorities to pay a compensation of 2 lakh rupees for Lakshman who has been unnecessarily interrogated in this particular case. Okay, in this particular case, what I want to tell you is a clear information has to be given from when it has happened, through which IP address it has happened. Okay, if there is a negligence also, there will be a punishment to the agency which will act negligently. Okay, if he has been proved that he has done that, then it will be a false on that particular person. So here what I want to do is, the investigation has been taken place according to Section 69 of Information Act. The police or the investigating agencies has approached that Airtel, that IP address providers, all these they have approached and they have taken the information. This, the service provider, they cannot deny that they will not give the information. In any of the case, they have to give the information. Okay, that is under Section 69 of Information Technology Act. Next, Section 60, Protected System. There are some systems, the appropriate government may notify the computer or a computer to a system to be protected. Okay, they can notify that certain systems are protected, nobody can access that particular system, only authorized user can access that particular system, then that will be called as protected systems. Okay, under Section 70, the government can declare particular system as a protected system. Okay, if any person who secures the access to the protected system will be punished with an imprisonment which can extend up to 10 years. For example, some information related to the election. Okay, some information related to the election is stored in any of the system, then that will be called as a protected system. Okay, then it will be called as a protected system. If somebody accesses the information, if somebody enters into that particular system, okay, unauthorizedly, then that will be treated as a criminal act under this particular section, and he will get a imprisonment up to 10 years. he will get an imprisonment up to 10 years. That is under Section 70 of Information Technology Act. Okay, so Section 71 of Information Technology Act, penalty for misrepresentation. Whoever makes the misrepresentation or suppresses any material fact from the controller or certifying authority for obtaining the digital signature certificate shall be punished with an imprisonment for a term of 2 years or with a fine up to 1 lakh or with both. Okay, misrepresentation. If somebody gives a misrepresentation, okay, this is like a personation also. Okay, and he takes a digital signature certificate by representing that he is that only person who is taking by giving his false name or whatever may be, then it is known as misrepresentation under section 71 of Information Technology Act. He will get a 2-year imprisonment or a fine up to 1 lakh or with both. Okay, so that is for the misrepresentation under section 71 of Information Technology Act, my dear friends. Okay, next, penalty for the breach of confidentiality and privacy, section 72. If any person has secured access to any electronic record, book, register or correspondence, okay, information, document or other material without the consent of the person concerned, okay, discloses such records, shall be punished with an imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years or with a fine which may extend up to 1 lakh or both. Okay, for example, electronic record, if somebody secures the electronic records or a book or a register, okay, without giving any information, for example, if somebody accesses the email ID of another person, okay, then it will be a breach of confidentiality. Facebook access, or if somebody accesses the mobile phone and takes out the confidential information, okay, which is stored, okay, that will be a serious offense, okay, with respect to section 72 of Information Technology Act. Okay, where a person who unauthorizedly secure the access, then he will be punished with an imprisonment and a fine, or it can be a both. Okay, he can be fined and also he can be put an imprisonment for 2 years. Okay, that is a section 72 of Information Technology Act. Next, 73, false digital signature certificate in certain particulars. No person shall publish a false digital signature certificate with the knowledge that the CA has listed in the certificate not listed. Okay, and the subscriber has not accepted it. The certificate is revoked or suspended. Okay, nobody shall use that particular digital signature certificate. One person will take a card, debit card, and he will not at all use it. And if another person takes the access of that credit card and if he misuses that, then it will be punishable under section 73 of Information Technology Act. Any person who contravenes the provisions shall be punished with 2 year imprisonment and a fine of 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so here each and every offense in the sections, in the different sections of IT Act, will clearly tell you about what the section will tell, what is the offense, how and all the offenses will be created, and what will be the punishment for that particular offense will also be given, is also given in that particular section. Okay, depending on that particular section and other sections which are involved, which are relevant in that particular case, the person will get the penalty or punishment in that case, whatever it has been done. Okay, so next, section 74, publication for fraudulent purposes, section 74. Whoever knowingly or unknowingly creates, publishes, makes available DSC for any fraudulent purpose, he will be punished. Okay, if he publishes the informations, okay, knowingly, and creates, if the digital signature certificates are published, okay, knowingly, okay, then he will be punished for that particular offense. What is an imprisonment up to 2 years and a fine up to 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so this is under Section 74 of Information Technology Act. So with this, my dear friends, let us conclude today's session about the different types of offenses which will be done under section, under different sections of Information Technology Act 2000, and the punishment for the same, okay, and the different case studies under the different sections. Okay, so each and every sections are very much useful, okay, for the examination point of view, and also for the information's sake also, these sections are very much important. As an IT engineers, information technology engineers, you should know the different sections, what is the fine or the punishment which will be there for the violation of different acts under section under IT Act. Okay, as that you should know all these facts. Okay, with this, let us conclude today's session, and next, in the next sessions, we will take up some other offenses which are listed in Information Technology Act 2000. Okay, my references are your reference book and the BARE Act of Information Technology 2000. Okay, thank you.